can see it's an impact day because there's been the threat for strong, possible severe storms, and we're tracking a cluster of storms right now that's developing over the North Shore, and that's where the greatest risk for possible severe weather is, and that's going to be this level 2 risk of severe storms that extends in through tonight. And we'll get to that in just one second. What I want to show you, though, is going to be also some of those risks of severe weather coming up in our particular outlook here. There was a special weather statement here for parts of the North Shore here in Washington Parish, but that has soon since gone away. But this is what I'm talking about. This could expand into more storm activity. Bogalusa, heavier downpour. Franklinton's got the rain. It's been through Roseland, Independence here too. Holton getting the heavy rain right now. Pine Cliff, Pine, Sheridan, State Line, there it is. And over the Pearl River, eventually this will spread over towards Nortac, Derby, and then you get to Henley Field, Millard, and Poplarville would be in here too. Varnado, can't forget about you as well. So this is what I'm discussing here, this risk of severe storms, a level 2-in-1 risk going for the North Shore and South Shore. It should be an impact day than what we have with this particular outlook here. But that shows that we do have a low risk that some of those storms could pose a tornado threat, especially here for the North Shore, but it's a very low threat. It's 2% chance. But this is why we've made it an impact day, because that threat exists. But as you're going to see in some of the information coming up here in just a bit, you're going to see that this chance that it develops into something a little bit stronger, really the chances are going down as we're 6:17 here in the evening hours, and we'll only get less energy going through the next several hours. Real-time temperatures feeling like it's still 100 here in town. So we've got some weak fronts that have moved into the area, and typically that we can find like this in this part of the year, we can find that we've got some strong severe storms across these fronts and across the region here. So there's a look at one leftover front. There's another front that eases in from the north, but again, they don't really move through. They just stall out as they get close to the region. They interact with systems rolling through the atmosphere, and so we get one round of storms, another round of storms, and then leftover energy from that when we get the heat and humidity for the next day. And we look at what's happening with Doppler radar, and we put that with what's going on. We could just see some storms or two if that develops into something more of the next few, but really the chances are going down, and really the threat those storms could be severe are getting really, really low. Temperature 70s tomorrow morning, but once we get through tonight, there's another chance of some strong storms tomorrow, and I think they're more widespread in nature. We started about 11 o'clock, storms developing, scattered in nature. There could be some hefty storms at times, and if we get more storms throughout the day, that means more clouds, could be a bit cooler. Very lowest level threat 1, marginal risk of a storm being severe with a strong wind gust and some locally heavy rain, so it's another impact day. But heavy rain and lightning are still topping my list for severe threats, even tonight through tomorrow. Maybe a strong wind gust, can't rule out that very weak variety tornado if one could form, but it's a really, really low threat. I got us into the 80s tomorrow for highs, then we go into Wednesday, and I could see some more scattered storms here too. I got us up to about 90, and there's no official threat for severe weather then, but I could see one that gets issued at the last minute. It would be a low threat like what's tomorrow. So storms likelier throughout the day, Tuesday, Wednesday. I want you to have your rain gear. More storms means slightly cooler, but we do have that risk, the low risk of storms being severe, and even that locally heavy rain threat. We'll just continue to find more widely scattered storms along those leftover fronts, even through the Father's Day weekend. We now have 3 tropical waves. I'm watching that Central American gyre closely. Don't see anything forming out of it. This isn't showing anything of any organization, nor is this complex of storm activity off the coast of Africa doing anything. So the National Hurricane Center is also showing a plume of Saharan dust that could be coming into play to limit development, saying nothing happening over the next 7 days, which is our best news. WDSU First Warning Weather 7-day. We've got the impact day tonight, tomorrow, for the chance and risk of severe storms. It's a low threat. Temperatures down a bit, but I would expect more storm activity and then a chance of storms through Father's Day weekend.